Essentially, rectifiers convert alternating current, AC, to direct current, DC. They do this through the use of a component that only allows one-way flow of electrons. This is exactly what a diode does. In the previous lab, you looked at half-wave rectifiers. This type of rectifier uses a single diode and, as the name would suggest, allows only half of an AC waveform to pass through to the load. With only one half of the input reaching the output, the mean voltage is lower, and while the output is unidirectional, it's pulsating. Much more filtering will be required on a half-wave rectifier than on a full-wave rectifier. The full-wave rectifier converts all of the input waveform to one polarity, either negative or positive at its output. Since both polarities are converted instead of one being blocked, this yields a higher average output voltage. This configuration also creates a pulsed DC output, but the pulses are closer together and easier to smooth or filter with the use of a capacitor. Although the full-wave rectifier produces a smoother unidirectional output than the half-wave rectifier, neither of them produce a constant voltage. To achieve steady DC from a rectified AC supply requires a smoothing circuit or a filter. The simplest form of filtering is a reservoir capacitor or a smoothing capacitor placed at the DC output of the rectifier. Without rectifiers, virtually none of our electronics would work at all. We would need to generate and distribute DC power. The main application of rectifiers is to turn AC power into DC power. Since almost every electronic device requires DC power to operate, it means there's probably a rectifier in there somewhere. Converting DC power from one voltage to a different voltage is more complicated. A common method is to first convert DC power to AC power, but at a frequency much higher than the 60 Hz distribution power. This higher frequency, usually tens of kilohertz, requires a smaller transformer, and if the frequency is high enough, will operate silently to most human ears. A transformer is then used to change the voltage of this high-frequency AC signal. And finally, another rectifier is used to convert this new voltage back to DC. This very common type of power supply is known as a switching supply and is found in most modern electronic components. Rectifiers are used to supply the direct current required by electric welders. Rectifiers are also used for the detection of amplitude-modulated, or AM, radio signals.